friends, I am Dr. Awdhesh Singh and I welcome you to Awdhesh Academy. We are now at Units and Measurement, that chapter of class 11th. In the first lesson, we have learned what are the different units of measurement. Today, we are going to learn about how to measure long distances. Friends, we are very familiar with measuring a small distances. Suppose you want to measure the distance of your room, you can easily take a meter gauge or a meter scale and you can measure the distance. But how you are going to measure the distance? Suppose you have to measure distance between earth and sun. So it's almost impossible to measure a long distance like that. So for that we use a terminology and we use certain techniques, and those techniques we are going to learn today. So one of the very important techniques is called parallax method. What is parallax method? Let us try to understand. Suppose I take a pencil and see it from left eye, it will be at a different position, and suppose we see it from the right eye, it will be at a different position. So our brain has a wiring or a system that it immediately, you know, compare the picture of left and right eyes, and then it finds the distance or the depth of the object. You may not be so familiar with that, but let us try to do an experiment, a very interesting experiment. Now here I am taking a pencil and here I am taking a pencil also. Now right now my both eyes are open and I want to just put it on one after another and I can easily do it. You can see it is very easy to do it because I can measure the depth because both my eyes are measuring its position and my brain able to assess the depth. Now I am closing one of the eyes and then trying to do the same thing again. Now you see that however best I try, I am unable to do it, because what happens that if I am going to see only with one eye, I will not be able to see the depth. And this is the principle which is called parallax method, and this method is used for measuring long distances. So we have understood what is parallax, that if the same object sees it a different position from the left eye and from the right eye, and that is called parallax. And the distance between the base, that is the between the eyes, for example, it is called basis. And this is the principle which we can use to measure the very long distances. So let me explain that. Now let us learn how to use the parallax method for measuring the long distances. Now here we see that this is the point, this is an object, and we want to measure the distance d of this object. Now from A, this is the position, and if we move from A to B point, the position changes and there is an angle theta which is subtended between the two. So we know the distance between A and point B because this is what we are physically moving, but we don't know the distance between S and A or S and B because this is a very long distance. But we know what is the value of theta. So as we know that if we take this distance as two big distance, in that situation the arc which is there between A and B and the length of the straight line length will be almost equal. So if D is too big as compared to B, in that situation what will happen, that arc AB will be almost equal to AB straight line. And we know that if we define radial, the radian theta is equal to AB divided by the distance D. And so what happens, that the distance D will be equal to AB divided by theta. So we know AB, we also know theta, and so if we substitute these two values, we can easily know what is the value of D. So by this method, we can find out what is the value of D. We can use the parallax method for measuring the dimensions of a planet also. For example, let us say we want to measure the dimension of moon. So here is the moon and we are here. In that situation, what we do is that we find out what is the angle which is subtended here. Let us say we call it alpha. And from here we have measured the distance. By using this method, we have measured the distance. And let us say this dimension is D. The dimension, I mean the diameter of the moon is D. Then we can use this formula, D by D is equal to alpha, and therefore the dimension d of the moon is equal to d into alpha. So we can find out so easily that not only by using the parallax method we can find the distance between a very distant object, but we can also find the dimensions of that particular object, for example the dimension of the moon. We must understand the importance of this parallax method, and this radian distance which is there, this alpha angle is measured in radian. Let me now explain the concept of radian. Radian, as you know, is the basically the ratio between the length of the arc and the radius of the particular circle. So as we know that the complete radius of the arc is equal to 2 pi r, and therefore if we measure the complete circle and the see the entire angle, then this angle will be equal to 2 pi r upon r, and that is equal to 2 pi. And in the normal trigonometry with this angle is 360 degrees. So 360 degrees is equal to 2 pi radian, and therefore 1 degree will be equal to 2 pi upon 360, and that is equal to 1.74 into 10 to the power minus 2. This is a dimensionless quantity because it is basically the ratio of two distances. Now if you want to measure 1 minute, 1 minute is the angle which is equal to 1 degree divided by 60, and that means equal to 1.74 into 10 to the power minus 2 divided by 60, and this means basically what is the distance, that is 2.9 into 10 to the power minus 4. Now we want to know what is the radian value of 1 second. Now 1 second is equal to 1 minute divided by 60, and if we calculate like this we find that this comes to be 4.85 into 10 to the power minus 6. So we have understood in this lesson as to number what is the meaning of radius, then 1 degree is equal to how many radians, and 1 minutes and 1 second equal to how many radians, and this minutes and seconds are very important criteria when we are measuring the long distance because the diversion is very very small. So let us solve one problem based on this parallax method. So let us say there is a tower C here. There is a tower C here. Here is the person, and you want to measure the distance of tower C. What you do is that on the infinite, first you are on some point which is a very infinite distance. That means suppose moon is there. Now you stand in such a way that moon and this point is in the same line. So here the angle made between moon and this particular object is 0. Now from here I moved 100 meter, and then because the moon position will also be simultaneously shifting because this line will continue to be parallel line, so the moon position will also remain same. However, this position will now change. And let us say that this angle is now theta, means theta. So that means from here when you are seeing, the angle between moon and the angle with the object is now theta. Since these two lines are parallel with each other, so this theta is also equal to this theta. And so what happens that we know that theta, if you take 10 theta, then 10 theta is equal to 100 divided by AC, and therefore AC is equal to 100 divided by 10 theta. Now in this particular question the theta is given that it is 10 40 degrees, and the value of 1040 is equal to 0.8391, and therefore this distance become equal to 190 meter. So as we have seen that from this example, you can see that we can measure the distance of AC without actually having any measuring equipment by simply measuring the distance between two points and the angle which is subtended between them. So I hope that you have been able to understand this particular problem, and now we will go to the next one. The moon is observed from two diametrically opposite points A and B on Earth. The angle theta subtended at the moon by the two directions of observation is 1 degree 54 minutes, and given the diameter of the Earth is about 1.276 × 10⁷ meter, compute the distance of the moon from the Earth. So this is the problem. Now let us see the solution. Now moon is here and Earth is here. The Earth dimension, this is given, and this is the angle. Let us say this angle is alpha, and we know that this is the diameter of the Earth. So and let us presume that this is the distance between Earth and moon, then we know that alpha is equal to d upon small d. And therefore, the distance which you want to measure is equal to t upon alpha. Now, both the things are given to us. D is equal to how much? That is equal to 1.276 × 10⁷. And alpha is equal to 1 degree 54 minutes. We have to convert that into radians. Now, how we convert that into radians? First, we will convert this 1 degree 54 minutes into seconds. So, 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, and so 1 degree 54 minutes is equal to 60 plus 54, and that is equal to 114 minutes. And then we can substitute this value, and 114 minutes is equal to 114 × 60 seconds. So, this is equal to this many seconds, and if we convert that into radian, then 114 × 60 × 4.85 × 10⁻⁶. So, this is the value in radians. And so, once we substitute this value here, then we get the distance answer as 3.84 × 10⁸ meters. So, you have seen how we can measure the distance between moon and the sun by measuring the angle. So, I hope that you have understood how to measure long distances, what is parallax, and by using this particular principle, how we can measure long distances. Thank you very much. If you have liked this video, please share your comments and give your suggestions. Thank you very much.